Okay, so once the engine is in, let's do some more installation, okay? This is the oil filter relocation kit along with the oil cooler kit, all in one from the name of this guy. I'm trying to find his logo here. Here we go. Mfactory. So this is the Mfactory kit. I don't think they make it anymore, but I don't know. There you go. Big oil cooler right there. And I'm going to attempt to install it. So my idea is we're going to have to put it over here, right down there where the oil filter's at. Run it underneath this little crack over here, and then somehow put it on this side. Actually, I'm gonna run it the other side. I'm gonna run it over here and put it just in this general area. That might work too. We'll see. Oh, and I forgot to tell you guys, the F2K kit also comes with this. These are the drive shaft shop 2.9 axles. I think they're rated for almost 500, like 495 or something like that. But there it is. Drive shaft shop. And I got these in the 36 millimeter splines up here because I got the JDM ITR hubs on there. So they basically changed those up for me, no additional charge. Okay, what else we got? Last look at the engine. Probably have to install the axles now so I can see what my clearance issues are everywhere else. Alright? Alright, y'all. Let me turn off the stereo first. Here we go. I've been kind of just putting stuff together and testing more things and basically just cleaning up the car. It's been so dusty for a long time. And found a couple of parts lying around, so I had to put them on the car. Like for example, here's a first for you, the entire Honda world. We're gonna put a 911 turbo lip on a Mugen bumper, and I've just made the measurements. It's a little off, but with a little bit of help from the heat gun, should be very very doable. Okay, so here's the 911 turbo lip on the Mugen bumper. There you go. It's a little off, but the cool thing is this cutout on the lip actually lines up with the lines here and here. So it actually looks pretty good. Front and back. I mean left and right. See? And it is a little short. I mean a little long, so we'll have to maybe cut off 3 inches. Probably cut it there, or cut it here, cut that off, and just move that in and plastic weld it back on, something like that. It should look pretty nice, actually. And yeah, it's not going to be this low. Once I put my 17-inch rims back on, it'll be a lot higher. Like, this black lip will probably be at that right there, which should be fine, which is the look I was looking for. Headlight harnesses. It's a fog light harness that I still have to run for the fog lights. And let's see, there's a bunch of other wires that I tossed out. That's the water bottle. Here's the inside of the car, completely stripped out. It was just too dirty to clean it. Still haven't cleaned it. Threw most of the stuff away, but I still gotta vacuum it. Here's the steering wheel of choice. This is the Sparco. Oh, let me try to illuminate. There it is, the Sparco. I think it was the 215 and the Recaro. I think it's SPD racing seat. A bunch of junk. I know my garage is a little dark already, so I'm just trying to use a flashlight to help illuminate everything. And there it is. Wiped it down a little. And here's the rear wing. Just an aftermarket Type R spoiler with the gurney flap, carbon fiber gurney flap, along with Don't open up the door. Get some more light going. There it is. The European taillights. I know a lot of people don't run them, but when they do, they kind of run it in this setup right here. I'm still missing the fog light. I'm going to put it right here. But nothing out of the unusual for a Type R. Oh, let's go around the other way. That's how it looks right now. It's coming along pretty good. And here's all the shit that I take out of the car. It's all in here. And more carpet stuff. Carpets. Interior pieces. Random interior pieces. Civic steering wheel. Integra steering wheel. Fenders right here. It is windy today too, and it's cold. It's probably only getting, it's probably just like 45 degrees right now. I'm still working on the car. It's coming along pretty nice. Like I said, if no one's ever seen this gurney flap before, there's another close-up for you. Looks like that. Nothing special. You might throw in a GT wing or something later. There it is. Here's the car. Walking back up to it. As I said, all the fuse boxes and the right side of the engine wiring harness is here. I'm only going to be using maybe 5 or 6 of these connectors out of probably 15 or 20. And yeah, there's trash everywhere. It's got grass everywhere. But that's where the vacuum cleaner comes in, and we got to vacuum this guy out. And we got to change those pedals out too. We got the Type RX pedals coming in. And then we gotta put the dash and the heater core, AC core. Not running an AC, but I'm gonna have to hollow out that core and throw it back in here. Or actually go buy the non-AC EG core. And that should work pretty well too. So take a mental picture, and sooner or later you're gonna see this shot again. And it'll have a dash, it'll have all types of things in here now. Oh yeah, and you'll have a carpet too. I don't plan on running rear seats, but I'll probably put the rear seats back in just for shits and giggles until I can get like a roll cage or some sort. But there it is. I sat in it yesterday. It was real nice. Speaking of real nice,